சதாசிவசமாரம்பாம் சங்கராச்சாரியமத்யமாம் அஸ்மதாச்சாரியபர்யந்தம் வந்தே குருபரம்பராம். Your presence is weightlessness. Let you be very clear. This is an important key to understand this whole sutra. Daman dakshobha sambukta sukshmagnitilakakritim bindum shikante hrutaye layante dhyayato layaha. Layante means non-existence or weightlessness. Even weightlessness is not a right word because I don't have any other word. I am using that word. Please understand the truth which I am expressing, which I am explaining. That will give you an idea. Beautiful sutra. Layante dhyayato layaha. It says, become weightless and enter into the laya, means beyond the mind, the weightless space itself. Let you become weightless and enter the space beyond mind. The key is your presence is weightlessness. You can see in your life, if you are feeling heaviness in some part of the body, you have not given your presence to that part of the body. You have not attended that part of the body. If you have a knee pain or stomach pain, just put your awareness on that area for 10 minutes. Simply you will see the pain will disappear. I tell you, because not only I practiced, there are so many of our devotees, disciples who are doctors, medical doctors have practiced this technique. And they say it really works, Swamiji. All you need to do is, where you have pain, just put your awareness in that area. Do not remember the word pain, just drop that word and look what is happening in that area. Just see what is happening in that area. Just relax. Just give your presence and you will see, simply experience the weightlessness. Not only with your body, even with other persons, even in the outer world, if you are feeling heavy with somebody, give your attention, the weight will disappear. You will carry your heaviness as long as you don't have courage to give your attention to that person, as long as you don't have courage to open with that person. If you can open up and drop the heaviness, you will see even your relationship becomes weightless. You will not have weight in your head. All your ego is nothing but you not giving your presence, you not giving your awareness to that part of you. Wherever it hurts, whether it is physical, mental, in relationship wise, give your awareness, give your presence. Immediately, that hurting will disappear, because your presence by its own nature heals. Your presence, your very presence has got the power to heal. People ask me, Swamiji, for your meditation techniques, for your healing, your presence is necessary. I tell them, my presence is not necessary, your presence is enough. For my healing to work, for my meditations to work, my presence is not necessary. Your presence is enough. But you need to give your presence. You forgot how to be present. That is why you are depending on my presence. If you can be present, you don't need my presence. You don't need my presence. You are caught with so many things. You are caught in so many things. even if you are present physically, never ever think you are present here. You can see in your life, morning when you get up and brush your teeth, already your mind is in the office, thinking and planning. When you are sitting in the office, already you are in the house, trying to clean and do something. When you are in the house, already you are in the temple or beach or in the discourse, thinking what you are supposed to do going there, and what you should do, what you are supposed to do and what you are not supposed to do, with whom you want to fight, with whom you want to relate, and what you plan everything. When you are in the lecture, already you are sitting here and thinking when to go back to the house. I don't know when you will finish the lecture, and I don't know when the energization will be over. I don't know how long it is going to take. I think in the gap itself, I will go away. I have to go. It is getting too late nowadays. The energization is ending only in 11 o'clock. You are sitting and planning. Be very clear. If you are here, you are not here. That one thing is sure. If you are here, you are not here. You forgot how to be present. You forgot how to be simple. You forgot how to be relaxed. You forgot how to be. That is why you are constantly dependent on my presence. If you can relax into your presence, you don't need my presence. Shiva says, your presence is weightlessness. Layante means nothingness, disappearing. By your very presence, you are weightlessness. For example, feel how a cow is lying and he is there, he is eating, he is swallowing, he is drinking, but there is no being inside. He has got life, but there is no individuality. There is no personality. For your body to carry its regular things, for your body to live on this planet Earth, you don't need personality. You don't need individuality. Your body can be alive on this planet Earth without personality. Let it be very clear, constantly you are frightened, threatened by society unless you carry your identities, unless you hold on to your identities, you cannot protect yourself. But it is your identity which creates all physical and mental sickness. When somebody gives you torture, when somebody gives you suffering, you feel sick of them. But one thing which gives you constant suffering, which nags you whole day, you don't feel sick of that. That's your identity. Constantly you are being nagged, beaten, tortured, but you don't feel sick of it. Because society has taught you, without it, you can't live. Without it, you can't live. I tell you, without it, you will live in a much more beautiful way, in a much more wonderful way. Whenever it is necessary, automatically your bio-intelligence will awaken. Even if you have to fight, automatically your being will fight. Whatever has to happen, those words will come out, that body language will express, and you will relax. You will not be bothered. You will not carry that constant irritation. I have always seen people who do rehearsal to fight, when they are on the spot, they will not be able to fight. Because all the arguments which they prepared will not come to their memory. They would have prepared all the arguments. I have always seen these wives or husbands, after the fight is over, when they are sitting in the sofa in different rooms, that time all the arguments which you thought you should, which did not come to the memory, will come back. Whatever arguments which would have helped you to win, or you think would have helped you to win, which did not come at that time, will be coming in when you are sitting alone. And you will be ready with all these arguments. When he comes back from the office, you will start again. And suddenly again you will see after 2-3 statements you forget the big project or which you prepared or the big file which you prepared. It's not there again. And you wait. Again that night you will be sitting and doing your homework, remembering everything. And next day morning when you start again, you will miss. Person who fights with individuality, means having an individuality and fighting, even fighting you won't be able to do properly. Let you be clear. You always think with individuality you can protect yourself. You can't. Because with individuality, constantly you are dependent on your past experience. You are preparing arguments. If he says this way, I will tell this way. If he talks this way, I will talk this way. If he comes this way, I will come this way. You are ready with some 10-12 type of arguments. And one important thing, present is never going to be like a past. Even if he comes with the same argument, sometimes just because of your pressure or tension, you will not have exact counter argument. After fighting, after 1 hour, suddenly you will remember, "Arey, this is what I thought, now I forgot." You will be sitting and repenting. I think all of you will be able to relate with the example what I am saying. All of you would have gone through the same. Let it be very clear. Even in your life, you cannot protect you if you carry the identity, if you carry individuality, if you carry personality, because it is completely related to past. It is nowhere related to present. It's nothing to do with present. It is nothing to do with spontaneity.